Aren't you guys supposed to have another wise man? Aren't you short a wise man or two? Okay.
Ben, guys.
He was, well, I'm glad they drove up here tonight.
Yeah, that's nice. So. Art is going to drive here too.
Yeah,
she said she did.
Look at that. We got some cars after all.
Yeah,
it's nice. Okay, see the counter cars?
No.
There's a counter in the other room.
Saying, are we gonna have to bring some
Merry Christmas
painkillers and medication for you? We still don't have a camel. I was worried about that today.
Looks like we got a camel. They prefer wise guys. Okay, well.
Yeah, we were married on the 19th of December, so I knew she wasn't joking.
I only recognize some people behind the masks.
Yeah.
Oh, Sarah Calvert's watching. Hi, Sarah. Hi, Sarah. The two young ladies standing together are sisters. It's loving it.
Margie will be cruising through in a minute.
Oh, cool. Okay.
There's Vern. He's watching.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Vern McKay.
Bring them on camera.
Yeah. Say hello to them.
period.
That's cool. Hey Vern, this is Kent. Hope you can hear us. Merry Christmas.
So Liz Williams is watching.
What's that?
Liz Williams is watching now. See, this keeps a lot of news watching. This is what this is. You get to see it with the Facebook event. You get more kind of tell. You can tell with YouTube. It's like.
Anyway, the British up there and found the Indians. The Indians again saw these guys pulling like two.
Hola,
We're going to go interview the innkeeper tonight. The innkeeper of the Bethlehem Inn is right over here. We're going to see what he has to say this evening. So, we have an exclusive interview tonight with the innkeeper of the Bethlehem Inn. And so, tell me, sir, with all these people coming to pay their taxes, don't you think you should have made better accommodations than a stable for Joseph and Mary? Oh, yeah, you're right. There's paying taxes. We have to do that. Caesar has spoken, and all we can do is jump. That's right. I bet it's a real gold mine for you during this season, collecting the taxes.
Well, I hope you have a nice evening there, you know.
I appreciate that, Mr. Innkeeper. So, okay. Well, hey. Yeah. Well, I just want to ask, though, would you please put out some fresh straw for Joseph and Mary in the feed box? Did I read the contract?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. I don't know. I don't know. It's just, you know, we've got to have more hope than that, Mr. Innkeeper. All right. Well, thank you for attending the live nativity tonight, Mr. Innkeeper. Now let's go interview the wise men. I think I'll come over here and speak to the wise men tonight. Are you like Caspar, Balthazar, and Melchior?
Yep.
Are you? Okay. I thought those were just traditions, those names, huh? Those really are your names? Okay. So how did you guys get here? Like, did you ride camels or that one right there? Yeah. What are they named? Huh? They lost their ears along the way. Gosh, it must have been a journey. Oh my gosh, they walked their ears off. That's horrible. Says it in the Bible? Yeah? I hope that's in the book of Anesthesians or something. That sounds painful. Oh, okay. So, well, thank you, ladies. You know what? Truthfully, though, since I have studied these things a little bit, you know, we don't know that they were all men. They could have been women. And we don't even know how many there were. There could have been just two. Well, there could have been 20. Yeah. They could have ridden an elephant. No, I don't know. What do you think about that? Maybe horses? Ah, good question. Let's see. They came from the east somewhere. Some people would say, now, wouldn't it be interesting? Let's say that they came, so east of where the Holy Land would be one of two places. It could have been Persia, which would have meant that a bunch of Iraqis showed us how to worship Jesus. Isn't that interesting? Or it could be they were from Babylon. So Babylon would have been another place, which would have been modern day Iraq. So those are two places they could have come from. So, I mean, you guys could have come from. What do I mean they? I mean, you guys are the real deal. What am I talking about here? So, yeah. Well, I just thank you guys for making the long journey. And what's in your boxes? What gifts do you have here?
It's a secret.
It's a secret? I'm not allowed to see it? Okay. I hope you brought him something like to maybe some extra swaddling clothes or something. Diapers. Okay. Oh, well, it's good to see you, kings, royalty. Nice to see you tonight. Thank you for helping tonight. I really appreciate you. Let's see if we can interview the Holy Family themselves. Oh, my gosh. We have Joseph and Mary, and is that Gabriel on the top, hiding out up top over there? Okay, hey, you know what? Your social distancing is remarkable. I want to thank you for that. Good job. Yeah? So anyway, so how did you guys, so what are you doing here in Bethlehem?
Well, we were looking for a place to stay tonight. Couldn't find any houses, so here we are.
Okay, you couldn't find a place to stay? What, you didn't have any relatives or anything in Bethlehem? Or?
No, we traveled here from a long
way. Okay. Was it Nazareth that you came from? Yeah, I think that was Nazareth. I heard that you guys had come from there. How about, did Mary ride that donkey? Did you? Very good. Well, that's great. So where have you laid the holy baby? Is that a feed box?
Yes.
Goodness gracious. Yeah, manger, feed box, same. Well, guys, I guess it's better than like a, well, you know, some people put blankets and stuff in a hotel room dresser drawer and they'll lay a baby in that. They used to do that kind of thing. I don't know if they do that anymore. But, well, are you glad to have arrived here, Mary?
Yes, quite.
Quite, yeah? So what about that angel up there? That Gabriel, huh?
Yes.
You've been busy, haven't you, in this season? Yeah. You've been making a lot of visits. How many people have you, do you know who you've run into lately?
Many people.
Many people, okay. Did you maybe show up you visited Mary maybe?
I did.
Yeah? Okay. So like the heavenly host, did they all leave you? The rest of the army of angels are supposed to be here tonight? Oh, I know. They're only allowed to come 10. 10, we're only allowed to have 10 social distancing. Okay. Well, thank you, Angel, and Joseph and Mary. All right, let's see who's over here. The shepherds, okay. All right, can I interview the shepherds for a moment? Fantastic. Well, tell me, what do you like about shepherding? The sheep? They're fluffy, okay, very fluffy, that's wonderful. Are any of them bad? There are always some bad sheep? Okay, yeah? Would you go after just one that was lost? Okay. Yeah? Oh, all together, huh? Yeah? So is it pretty cold out here on the hillside at night, watching over the sheep? What do you guys do to kill the time? Sleep? Okay, could you say that a little louder? Oh, just cuddle with the fluffy sheep. Well, that wool would probably keep you warm. Yeah. Very nice. Very nice. So, let's see. Do you look in the sky a lot at night while you're out here? Yeah. Did you see there's a star somewhere around here? I mean, Oh, it's up over here, my right shoulder, the one hanging over the side of the... Yeah? Did you see it? Yeah, it brought you here. Well, now, wait a minute. I thought I'm interviewing the shepherds. I thought the wise guys were the ones that followed the star. Huh? Oh, well, you guys are some wonderful shepherdesses. It's nice to see you tonight. Thanks for coming on out and helping with the live nativity. So, all right, we're not going to film everything. Good to see you guys. Thank you all. Hey, how you doing?
Good. I get a picture of the kid.
Oh, yeah, sure. Good night, guys. Thanks for tuning in.